An independent samples t-test is used to determine if two groups differ on an outcome. With our sample data set, we could run a t-test to determine if males earn higher GPAs than females. Click Analyze, Compare Means, and Independent Samples T-Test. On the left, we see all the variables in our study, and on the right, we see a box for test variables and a box for grouping variable. Knowing which variable goes into the test and grouping boxes is very important. If we don't assign the right variables to these boxes, our calculation will be inaccurate. Always place the independent variable in the grouping variable box. In this case, the independent variable is student gender. So I'll click on student gender in the variable list and click the arrow to move it into the grouping variable box. Always place the dependent variable, or variables, you can have more than one, in the test variables box. In our example, the dependent variable is student GPA. So I'll click on student GPA in the variable list and click the arrow to move it over to the test variable box. The next thing we need to do is resolve any question marks. Notice the question marks in the grouping variable. I have to tell SPSS what codes I use to differentiate between males and females. So I need to click on Define Groups. I remember that I coded males as 1 and females as 2. So I'll type for group 1, the 1 for males, and group 2 will be the females, a 2. Next I'll click Continue. Now I'm ready to have SPSS run the calculation, so I'll click OK. In our output document, we have statistics. We can see that there were 4 males with a mean GPA of 0.297 and a standard deviation of 0.52, both with rounding. And then for females, we can see that there were 6 with a mean GPA of 2.69 and a standard deviation of 0.82, both with rounding. From these statistics, we can see that there is a difference between GPAs of males versus females, and that males have a higher GPA mean than females. However, the question becomes, is there a statistically significant difference, or could it happen by random chance alone? When we look at the test information, the box below, there is really only 3 things we need to look at, and that is the T, the degrees of freedom, and the sig to tail, the significance level, here on the top row. Here our T is 0.59, degrees of freedom is 8, and the significance level is 0.57. Keeping in mind we only reject a null hypothesis if it is below 0.05, we can see our significance level is 0.57, indicating there is not a significant difference between the GPAs of males versus female students, and this difference in GPA could happen by random chance alone 57% of the time.